Hello, everybody, and Happy New Year. We are we're kind of in high intensity COVID era now, and we're keeping people out unless they're really leaning in and want to see the art, because Sag Harbor is very busy. We've actually had a pretty good year. I'm gonna come around this way, Megan, you can go that way. You know, it's been a very long year. I'm gonna take this off now. It's been a very long year, but we've had a pretty solid year in the business, and I just wanted to point out that Sag Harbor has gotten really crowded. We have like this little bubble out here. It's like Boccaccio's tales. Everyone escaped the plague and came to their country houses. And I just want to say that my family, we actually had three generations under one roof. And if you go back in Instagram, you'll see my daughter vamping around the house like me at at Easter time.
As you know, I am an art curator. I've curated my entire house of the most wonderful paintings you could ever find in the universe.
Anyhow, we're still not out of the woods. I think the woods are gonna get a lot darker in the next few months. And I just want to let you know that we are very ready for a new year here at the Grenning Gallery. And our Normal Gems show is actually doing very well. New York has moved to Sag Harbor. There's almost double the number of households year round, and the town is busy. And I want to encourage those who are really interested in art to come walk through our orange velvet rope and look at some of these paintings, because it is happening. Paintings are moving. And we did get some works were delayed on their way to the Gem Show. So I actually have some brand new things I'm gonna show you today. We're gonna start actually with the Ben Fenske painting. Ben it usually spends a couple of months here, and we have a lot of new local landscapes that we then put in the next show. This was a major local landscape that he dropped off right before he left in late September. It is one of the, it's just a beautiful, beautiful image of the Sag Harbor Cove from the perspective of Secret Beach, which is a beach right over here in North Haven, looking towards Meshamek over here. Only Ben can make the clouds in the sky the focal point of a painting. It's just gorgeous. This is a very alive, vibrating, impressionist work of art by a classically trained painter. This is just a hint for what's coming for Ben Fenske's show next August, which hopefully by then we'll all be together at a normal opening reception. I want to show you two Anthony Ackrill paintings that literally just arrived. This is one of them. Actually, Megan, you can come in here. I'm going to put my thing back on. This is called Brinkmanship. It's just classic Anthony Ackrill. He's got a very quirky sense of humor, and he also loves to put different objects together for their sensual nature. Like I'm sure he was thinking about the shell of the egg against the rusty vice grip. And I think this is a perfect coronavirus painting. It's like the pressure of 2020. And you know, the egg is like a perfectly built protector of the sensitive things inside. I think that's a very beautiful, very classic Anthony Ackrill. We're really happy to have that. And this one is called Relapse. Mm-hmm. I thought it was just a swan on a tray. This is a found object. He usually paints on found objects. I think it's a pewter tray that he's then treated perfectly so that it will hold the painting for 500 years. But it's a gorgeous painting. He's got water lilies even in the background, but he's having a cigarette. I think it's great. Very funny, quirky sense of humor. And then on the subject of water lilies, we're just gonna zip by. We talked about this before, but I just want you to know that we are starting to plan for some very early preview socially distant studio visits for Darius Yektai's show, which is going to be a water lily show in June. And then the other thing that came in that's very exciting, we've been selling a lot of Amy Florence paintings. They've just really, like, people are buying 2, 3, 4 at a time. Just in time, about a week ago Friday, her paintings finally arrived. There was trouble shipping from Italy and from England. We had frames coming from one place, paintings from another. They arrived, Megan spent the day putting them together and in the frames, and voila. The large painting sold within 12 hours. Literally, you finished framing Friday night and Saturday morning was sold. This is called, is it Roses and Peonies?
Mm-hmm.
Roses and Peonies. I think it's a really interesting painting. And before it zips out of here, it's gonna be leaving in a week or two. I'm gonna be installing it in a contemporary home in Brooklyn. I just find this such an interesting shift where she's got this kind of foreshortened, she's resolved the negative space issue in any still life, but also in florals, they tend to be a little sweet, and she's gotten rid of that by creating all of these angular shapes in this mostly neutral tone background, and she's got a mirror here, which helps create some depth. And because she's used mostly neutral tones, the flowers look like kind of lyrical musical notes across a very neutral tone field. And the interest and the intrigue of this like twilight blue shadowed door frame is just a beautiful, it's a vertical and it's just a beautiful relief from the warm toned gray background and then the hot toned flowers. I just think this is a beautiful composition. Interesting, lively, and original. Very original painting. And I believe this is the largest Amy Florence painting we've sold. Is that true?
Mm-hmm.
That's true. And we're sorry to say that she and her family, her parent, her mom and her dad, are hunkered down in their apartment in, or their place in London because they've all been tested positive, I believe. And so she told me that she's there and they're not allowed to see their family over the holidays, which is sad.
Mm.
It's like the coronavirus bombs are dropping a little closer. I just got a text that my boyfriend's daughter just tested positive. So anyhow, another original and interesting still life by Amy Florence just came in. I think that's Salt and Potatoes.
Yes.
But again, she's constrained her palette. I think her compositional sense, she's got lost edges. She's paid a lot of attention to the background and the foreground. So as an abstract impression, I think it really, really works. I just think that's lovely. And then here is a very traditional, simple, but very elegant floral. There's roses and there's another rose painting that we'll show you over there. I think the velvetness of these leaves and then the crispness of the leaf on the ground and the water, it all, without a lot of effort, she's creating a lot of sensuality. I don't know how she's doing it, but it's really working. And then this, when this came in, I was like, oh my God, that's just so, it's very graphic. It almost feels like, it feels like an explosion. It feels like wallpaper or something, but it's a different cropping. She's obviously looking at the riotous bouquet up close. And again, this one also works. I find it interesting that she's taken this kind of non-flower, non-showy, some kind of a daisy or a sunflower is at the center.
And then you have those eucalyptus leaves that have that matte feeling. It's just really working. So I think this is an artist very much to watch, and we're gonna be getting more works, but we unpacked. I think, Megan, you did a little scan of that on Instagram. We unpacked these paintings and they're selling. So come now, because we're not gonna hold back on her work. I also wanna show you Maryann Lucas. She dropped off two brand new florals. And as you'll see in the posting, we're gonna put out a constant contact. There's just a subtlety in the colors that's deeper and richer than I've seen in her work before. And I can't quite put my finger on it, but I can taste it. My eyes can taste it. The pale pinks and the purples and the yellow in the back. Also, I think the composition is very, very clean and simple, and I love the challenge of putting a high key background. I also love this very simple white frame. So I highly recommend this painting. It's a steal. It's called Sweet Peas and Peonies. And then this is really, we had a great painting by Ben Fenske of zinnias this summer. And this is, I think, a really interesting. It's almost like it's like a family tree, and each one is a different character in the family. I see her observing each flower as it is, very sincerely, instead of thinking, oh, I know how to paint zinnias. I almost feel like each flower has been given, it's getting its own portrait done. And as a result, I think it is just a really beautiful, beautiful painting. Fun. And again, she's gone with a completely white background, really nothing going on. And it's working for me in this painting, really, really works. And this one is called Arrangement of Zinnias. And then we also have, this was at the show in the opening. It's a local landscape by Maryann Lucas, beautifully observed. That's like her childhood romper area, where she would romp with her friends and family. And well, let's just finish on Amy's. This is just a really beautiful, again, another very simple, beautiful floral by Amy. It's Roses One, is what it's called. And she's been getting a lot of compliments on this frame. It's a similar frame to the peonies and roses. Anyhow, this is, you know, these, I don't know if you remember, but a lot of these paintings are changing out. They're selling, they're moving, and we are open, and we're gonna extend this show, and paintings are gonna, if you buy a painting in this show, you're allowed to take it, because there's so many new things coming in this time of year. We're putting new things up. We're gonna extend this show through January 18th, which is Martin Luther King weekend. And we'll probably have some painting work done. You know, we'll close up for 2 weeks probably to get the place repainted at the end of January. But please call us or come in. It's best if you go online and tell us what you're looking at. Oh, we also have a new van. We bought a new van, which we'll show you pictures when we get the Grenning Gallery logo on it. But we are now able to move much larger works, because as you can see, the painters are doing much larger paintings, and the clients seem to need them. So I wanna wish everyone a happy, happy new year. And let's pray that 2021, let me take this off. Let's pray that 2021 ends without masks. See you guys later.